So the big guy here thought I should introduce myself, being new and all, and I thought, what a brilliant idea. So, Android Central family, meet Tshaka Armstrong. Thank you. Well, I'm a Sagittarius. I like long VR walks on the beach. My favorite Android is 15, DBZ, but seriously, so I'm an Android enthusiast, much like many of you. Started a nonprofit in 2009, teaching internet safety and digital literacy to thousands of students here in Los Angeles and all over the country through a couple other organizations. I've been writing, been on TV as a tech journalist. I've been doing this for quite some time, and I am really excited to be part of the team and help you guys out there get the best of what Android has to offer through the articles and edutainment we provide for you here on YouTube and on the site. Well, that sounds good. So let's do what we came here to do, and let's talk about some apps you may want to put on your phone right now. Now, before we jump into it, we have 7 categories of apps. You can skip to the ones you want and see what we're covering by hitting the video description and looking at the timestamps, the chapter markers we've put in there for you. Now, when we talk communications, there's so many apps we can get to, but I'm going to pick 2 that I think are going to profoundly, potentially impact your life and something you're gonna wanna put on your device right now. First off is an app that I poo-pooed at first called Marco Polo. Marco Polo is a kind of, it's a time-shifting, asynchronous video chat app, and it's actually quite brilliant in what it does. I remember when my wife first started using it, I actually was like, oh, you know, this is... there we go. That's the chat bot that helps you set up Marco when you first get into it. But when my wife first started using it, I thought it was kind of ridiculous. I really didn't want to get that into it. But it actually is really, really well done. And it is a really cool app. So you go in here, you leave a video message for somebody, they respond with the video message back. The interface looks like this. So you can see here, this is my wife and I talking to each other. You can see when I've talked to her where she has left me hearts and I've left her smiley faces while we're listening to each other's messages. So the cool thing, the cool functionality about this is as you're leaving video messages, you can go ahead and you can have all kinds of filters that you use, effects, voice effects, different things you can use to leave people messages, responses to their video messages. And if you pay for the annual subscription, it will allow you to do a host of other things. Like if you're responding to someone's video, let's say you're watching the video they left you and it's a life update, they're asking a question, hey, I have this person I'm seeing and these are the kind of things that look to me like they might be red flags, what do you think? As they're talking now with the paid version, you can leave responses to the questions that they're asking you in real time and pause the video. And when you're done recording your response, it'll play the video again where it left off. Definitely something worth checking out. The paid version is $59.99 for the year or $5 a month. They do give you a 7-day free trial so that you can check that out and see if it is something that's gonna work for you. Now, the next app we're gonna talk about is kind of an obvious one, but there's a reason why I wanted to bring this one into the discussion: Google Messages. So many of you may already be using Google Messages, some of you maybe not, but the reason why I bring Google Messages into the discussion here is because Verizon just announced, and this adds to T-Mobile and AT&T's previous announcements, that they're going to make RCS or RCS messaging, or in this case, Google Messages, the default on all their Android phones going forward in 2022. So I think it's important to add this app because also working from home, many of you may be sitting in front of computers at home all day and don't necessarily need to be texting from your phone when you have your computer right here in front of you. And that's where Google Messages comes in. you can go to the web and actually respond to and send messages from the Google Messages app on the web. And that's great because that means that you don't actually have to be platform specific. You can do it from a Windows computer, from a Mac, you can do it from Linux, anything that has a web browser. You can just go to, and let's pull it up here, you can just go to messages.google.com. You'll be presented with this screen here, which gives you a QR code. You'll just hold your phone up to that QR code, and from the menu, you're gonna choose pairing, and then you'll be able to send and receive text messages from the web, from this browser window. You'll also be able to do Google Duo from the computer. The only thing you won't be able to do by connecting your phone to the web browser is make and receive phone calls from that web browser. The next category I want to talk about is VPNs. I think the most important reason to discuss VPNs right now is because many of you may be on vacation or on holiday, and you might want to watch, you know, I hope you're out and about actually seeing the sights and doing all the things there are to experience live. But maybe at the end of the day, you want to kick back and unwind with some of these shows that you've been binging. Well, that's what a VPN is gonna be great for. And I've chosen two that have the broadest connections with your streaming content. So each of these VPNs have unblocked Netflix, Disney Plus, and a few other streaming platforms that I'll put into the description below so you can see exactly which ones that they'll support for you. But ExpressVPN and Surfshark, those are the two that we took a look at. The reason why I took a look at Surfshark is because with Surfshark, when you connect out of your region, you'll be able to use unlimited devices. So you can have a family and pay for the plan, and then you'll be able to have all your family members be able to watch their programs, their shows. Again, when you're on holiday and you're out of your region and you want to connect and watch those shows. With ExpressVPN, you only get 5 devices on their plan. Right now, I'm connected to ExpressVPN. They have tons of servers in many, many countries here. They have a bunch of different features that you can access. Really good app. Let's get out of that one, disconnect, and let's open up ExpressVPN so you can check that out. There you see. And ExpressVPN from our testing here at Android Central seems to be a little faster, but it really is actually with both VPN apps, that speed is really going to depend on the server that you connect to. So different country servers, different server locations are going to give you different results as far as your speed goes. Now, with both apps, if you haven't used VPN, you're going to have to connect to Wi-Fi or a cellular network and then use the VPN. So if you're unfamiliar with that, VPN is not your internet connection. VPN just encrypts data that travels along that connection. So the next category we're gonna get into is home screen customization, launchers, widgets. Obviously, that's a big deal on Android. So we're going to talk about two of my favorites, Smart Launcher, which just had some major updates and features in update 5. So Smart Launcher version 5. And we're gonna talk about a very simple launcher to use called Niagara Launcher, which doesn't have as many options as Smart Launcher, but it's a great launcher for those of you who are wanting to get into home screen customization and widgets and all those types of things without having to spend hours upon hours, if you want to, doing that customization like you can with Smart Launcher. So we're gonna go ahead and launch Smart Launcher 5. You can see here, I customized the icons and how they look. You can tap and hold on an empty space here, and then you can go into all kinds of settings. You really can get super granular. You can spend hours, literal hours, actually setting this up. You can change your icon. You can change your icon sizes. You can create whole widget pages. You can add your own custom categories to your app. So let's go into the app drawer here. And you see at the bottom here, you have all these tabs. So you have different tabs, your connections, your communications, your internet apps, your games, your media apps, utilities. But one of the great things is when you pay for the pro version, which is $6.99 a year, $16 for a lifetime membership, which is actually really worth it if you're into this, you actually can then go in and you can organize those drawer tabs in a variety of ways. You can do it from the icon color to the time or date that you installed the apps. You can even do it from most used. So it just gives you a bunch of other options for organizing those tabs. One of the other things you may lose here is you have the notification shade, which takes two pulls to get to now, but you can also go into the settings and set it up so that when you double tap, now you have your notifications back. So with Niagara Launcher, like I said, it's very basic. When you first set it up, it gives you the option to look at eight apps, your eight most frequently used apps on the home screen. But the great thing about Niagara Launcher is not only can you have those eight apps, you have your weather up top, you have your media, you have a widget that you can put in, which I put for my home automation. So it has my LifeX bulbs right there. So you can add those, but you can also, when you pay for the pro version, see all of your upcoming calendar entries with the weather information attached to them, your agenda items, and you can add these pop-up folders. So let's say, again, you have your eight apps, but you want a little bit more. You can add these pop-up folders, and that's going to allow you to add even more functionalities. You can also access your apps by alphabetical order so that if you don't have an app that's one of those eight apps, you can get to all those other apps really easily and really quickly by using the alphabetical order. You can also go to it that way too, which is kind of cool. So you have this little rubber banding that allows you to snap through the apps and move through them quickly in that fashion. So Niagara Launcher is really cool. You can also search for apps as well with the magnifying glass. Our next category, and you'll see why I'm kind of lumping these together as we get through them, is cameras and editing. So if you're on a device where you don't particularly care for the camera, I'm going to show you a replacement camera app that you can use. And then I'm going to show you two photo editing apps that you can use that are really good. First up, we're going to take a look at Open Camera. Open Camera is a camera replacement app that gives you a bunch of options, some of those pro level options, and it's still simple to use. So you get the exposure options, you can click the dots and you'll see you can choose the different resolutions, turning a timer on and off, all kinds of different things for you to play with, turn the focus to manual. So there really is just a bunch you can get into with the Open Camera, including if you're shooting video, you can choose to shoot video in the log profile setting, which gives you a flatter video image so that when you actually go to edit with the image, if that's what you're going to do, you can apply something called a LUT or lookup table so that you can better color correct or color grade the picture. After you take the picture, what do you want to do? Well, we're going to go to one that maybe you wouldn't have expected in this, and that is Instagram. So you can open up Instagram, and obviously you have all the filter options that you can go through. You have really granular editing in terms of adjusting. You have all these post-processing adjustments, so you can adjust the exposure, the contrast. So there are all those different types of options, but what do most of us do with our images? We share them on social. So Instagram, one of the largest social networks out there, allows you to then share directly to Instagram and to Facebook, which many of you are going to be sharing too. So that's why I'm including this. And then last but not least, in terms of the photo editing, and this one is really cool, this is Canva. Why I like Canva is because you can take it and you can pull in your photos and you have all these frames, all these templates that you can use, thousands and thousands of templates that you can add to and add your photos to and customize. So you go ahead and you're gonna pick a template and then you can pull in a photo from any one of their templates. and then add your own thing to it. So there's one of theirs, and then you can go ahead and replace, add one of your own photos to the background or any number of things. You can do so much with Canva. And the great thing with Canva is it actually works on the desktop too. So there's a desktop version of Canva. So you can use it from your mobile device and you can use it from the desktop. So it really is versatile for those of you who are working at home. One of my favorite functionalities is the nudge, and you can get very precise, very exact placement. So it's easier than just trying to grab the photo and move it around this way. Trust me, if you haven't used photo editing apps or image editing, these types of apps, you will thank me after using one that doesn't have nudge functionality. For some people, it can be a boring category, but I'm really in love with productivity. Being efficient and well-organized really helps you get through all the demands that life places on you. So I'm going to share with you my two favorite productivity apps. And in this case, that's going to be Evernote and Remember the Milk. First one up, Evernote is great because it allows you to do so many things. There's so much you can do with Evernote that it can be overwhelming for a lot of people. You have, you can create to-do lists. You can use it for project management. You can use it for shopping lists. You can use it to clip things you've seen on the web, which is what I use it for probably most often. And you can use it to record notes, pictures, receipts, business cards, any number of things. But I say, keep it simple, start with something easy to begin with. Start with using it for maybe just grocery lists or using it for your to-do list. So you can go in, you tap new, and that allows you to use the camera or to sketch something, to add an attachment, to make an audio note, to make just a standard note, to create tasks, and you can have subtasks within those tasks. The other thing that I said was I love using it for clipping things I see on the web. So here's an image I found of Kang the Conqueror. I'm gonna go ahead and choose to share that. I'm gonna click on more, and then I'm gonna pull up Evernote here. And you see, it pulls it up. It lets you choose a notebook because that's how you work in Evernote. You organize everything into notebooks, and then you have all your notes in those notebooks. The other organization app I love, and I'm going to show you this one because it is one of my favorites. This is Remember the Milk. Remember the Milk allows you to create to-do lists and lists and sublists, subtasks on those to-do lists. So the free version allows you to just, you know, have the app and it does everything you need it to do. The pro version allows you to install the app on as many devices as you want. And if you have a family, this is where this is a big deal. So what I've done is I've created one default list that is the grocery list. That specific list is for my family. So I made the grocery list the default list, so whenever they added anything to the list from whichever view they were in, it would automatically go into the default list, which was groceries. And the beautiful hook to Remember the Milk is that it also works with Alexa. You can add it to Alexa as a skill. So you can say to Alexa, Alexa, tell Remember the Milk to remind me to pick up peanut butter.
Task pick up peanut butter added.
Alexa, tell Remember the Milk to remind me to buy more coconut cream tea.
Task buy more coconut cream tea added.
Boom, and as you can see, right there, it's been added. This is a great way to making sure that everybody's involved in keeping that refrigerator and those pantries stocked. Okay, and now let's look at music players, media players, and music streaming apps. So let's get this in here. This is Sony's Xperia 1 Mark II. The reason why we use this is because it has a headphone jack, so I can listen to that lossless music. And we're going to talk about, speaking of lossless, first up in our music streaming apps, Apple Music. Why would you talk about Apple Music for Android devices? Well, because Apple Music, for me, has been excellent. I have looked up obscure hip hop tracks from like the 80s and 90s, and Apple actually has them. So their library is magnificent. But the other thing they just added this past week for Android users was they added lossless music. So let's go ahead and look at that album. So you can see here, as we looked into it, that the album actually shows you what type of music you have access to. In this case, we have the high-res lossless that you have access to, as well as Apple's digital master. So you have great options. You're gonna get spatial audio with this app. So that's Dolby Atmos. That is a beautiful thing with the right tracks. Dolby Atmos doesn't sound great on every track, but you actually depend on whoever's mastering. So there is a bunch of music. There are tons of songs on there that actually sound really good. It's just gonna be hit or miss depending on what you listen to based on how it was mastered. And next up, in terms of our music, I wanna show you two media players. The first is VLC media player. I use VLC media player. It's my Swiss Army knife. Videos, audio content, it really allows you to download all kinds of codecs so that you can play different types of content, play different types of audio and video. I do two things with this. Every time I set up an editing workstation or post-production workstation, I put VLC media player on that computer. It works on all platforms. And I put VLC media player on all my devices, iOS and Android. And so, like I said, it plays so many different things. It'll play your FLAC files, it'll play your video files, and it really gives you a bunch of different options on where you're going to connect with that music from. You can stream it from servers, you can stream it from your NAS, your network attached storage in your home, you can stream it from the cloud through the VLC media player. So it is a really solid, really robust, and it's free, without ads all in your face. And the other is MX Player. MX Player is really cool. I love MX Player. One of the things I love about MX Player is when you're playing a song, it has this animation which is hypnotic for me. I could stare at this thing for hours. And this animation is of an old record player, and you see it even has the arm there with the needle. And when you pause it, the needle goes off the record. And when you hit play again, the needle goes on the record. And when you pause it, it goes off and on and off and on. With MX Player, it has highly customizable interface options. You can go through the colors, the transparencies, the buttons, back and exit options, shortcuts, play, fast forward, reverse, speed, and seek time options. There is so much you can do with MX Player. It really is worthy of a standalone review just to go through all the functions and functionality. And those are seven categories of Android apps that I hope you'll find worthy of putting on your Android device. Hey, if you have any questions or you have any alternative apps that you use that you'd like to let me know about, go ahead and leave those in the comments section below. I'll get to them. Love chatting with you all online. I'm new here, as I said in the beginning, Tshaka Armstrong for Android Central. It's been a pleasure. Catch you on the next video.